Sir, I was going to ask you, now that the US has moved its embassy, don't you think now it's time for Britain to do the same?
No, we've got no plans to do so. We've been very clear that we didn't support the US move.
Yeah.
We've got no plans to move our embassy. We support the moves to a two-state solution, and we think the US is going to play a key role in the move, and we'll support any efforts, and we're obviously waiting for the Trump administration to bring forward its proposals.
Let's go to Tom. Tom, do you think the British embassy will anytime soon move the embassy, and do you think that British could play a larger role in this process?
Well, Michael Gove, who of course Mark will know well, actually suggested in an article in The Times shortly before he re-entered government that Britain move its embassy to Jerusalem as something useful towards the peace process, to make it clear that the future capital of Israel will be Jerusalem, or at least West Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
So I think actually that Britain and maybe other European countries, for example, the Czech Republic, where I am at present, is talking about moving its embassy to Jerusalem. And I don't think it's unhelpful to a two-state solution. In fact, I think it's helpful to establish some facts on the ground and make things clear and then make the Palestinians negotiate so they too can have an embassy within Jerusalem boundaries in future. Yes, I just wanted to point out that Donald Trump has had his entire life working in real estate, as has Kushner and Greenblatt and some of the other advisors to Trump. And in some respects, the Israeli-Palestinian dispute and conflict is a real estate conflict. And therefore, if you look at Trump's approach also to North Korea and other issues, I wouldn't say that moving the embassy was unhelpful. And, you know, we have to look at this in real estate terms. And whether it will work or not, I think Trump and his team do have a strategy here, and it's a different kind of strategy than has been tried in the past.
You think you have any hope for this Trump strategy?
Well, there is some evidence from what's happened with North Korea that his approach of kind of doing some things that catch people unawares actually can, you know, shake up the kaleidoscope and can lead to some things. Whether his approach will be successful in the Middle East, given all the complexities, I mean, only time will tell.